Hello guys, welcome to Clat Tips and Tricks, another session by co-host aniket. Today in this video we'll learn about the Clat 2008 previous answers. So let's begin without wasting our time. So guys, this is 2008 Clat paper. We will begin by commencing with the GK sections first. So let's begin with the GK section. First we will deal with GK. So question number 1 of Clat 2008 regarding GK, here it comes. The Supreme Court of India upheld a decision, the question number 41 which was there. As you see, it is related to the OBC case, the reservation basically about the creamy layer in the OBC. As you all know, for the OBCs there are creamy layer and non-creamy layer. First of all, for knowing the background, we must clear from where the reservation came. So the case which pertains to the reservation criteria was the Mandal Commission case, which is popularly known as Mandal Commission case, but in original the parties were Indira Swahane. It was the Indira Swahane versus Union of India. It is one of the landmark cases and regarding reservation. So which type of action it is? Question can come, which type of action is reservation? So if there is option called affirmative action, then you should mark the answer as affirmative action. So when this Mandal Commission was constituted, it was constituted in 1979 time during by the party of Morarji Desai, that is Janata Dal. During that time it was held. It is now later on known as the famous Mandal Commission. So the answer to this case is, since it is asking the court have excluded the creamy layer because it can compete with others on equal footing, because creamy layer have certain income limit. As you all know, at above income limit in OBCs there is no reservation. So pertaining to creamy layer there is an income limit, hence the person belonging to creamy layer option would be question option C. Moving to next question, question 42, what is hedge fund? Hedge fund, the answer for this question is option C. It is basically applied to minimize the risk of financial market institutions. As you know, the primary aim, you can say, it is only to apply the minimizing the risk. Like when we make some risk, we are knowing making the financial transactions in the market. So in order to safeguard ourselves, we use the term as hedge fund. Next question, what does strong rupee? The question number 43, as you all see. Now you see newspapers, there is always some currency exchange rates, like $1 so rupees, 1 euro so much rupees, 1 pound so much rupees. So whenever a rupee is strong, it always indicate that a balance of payment is surplus, as it means that more currency is flowing into our country rather than flowing out. It means that our currency is not the currency from which we are exporting, that is coming inside the country rather than we are spending on it. So answer for it will be option A, that is there is balance of payment is surplus. Next question, 44, independence in 2008, like this question is a repetitive, it could be answer is Kosovo. 44, option B. Name the finance minister who presented the highest number of budgets. As you see, this time budget was presented by which finance minister? You should be aware of the current cabinet ministers. This time the budget was passed by whom? I think you should better search it out, because the list of cabinet ministers is very important, as they can ask you any cabinet minister with their post. So let's leave to you to find out the answer. The answer to this particular question is Morarji Desai, who was the Prime Minister, also later on Prime Minister of India by Janata Dal. So answer is Morarji Desai, and the person next to him who is succeeding him is our former former president Mr. Pranab Mukherjee. Next question, who is the chairman of 13th Finance Commission? Actually now this question is not more relevant, because we have now 14th Finance Commission under Mr. Yave Reddy, YV Reddy. So according to this question, the answer is Vijay Kelkar. But if question comes regarding 14th Finance Commission, the answer would be YV Reddy. Next question, Indo-US nuclear deal was opposed. See, the answer to this question is that option C, that nuclear relations between India and USA will be governed by the Hyde Act. Basically, you should be aware that what was Hyde Act. So according to it, it was that during the nuclear deal with USA, our sovereignty was at stake. As you all know, our preamble guarantees the sovereignty, secularism, socialism, all that, secular democratic republic. So the word sovereignty is also in a constitution, so it was endangered, therefore it was opposed in parliament. The next question, 48, Vijay Mallya. Answer to this question is very simple, as we all know only one thing good about Vijay Mallya. One thing was Kingfisher, one thing was that he bought Tipu Sultan's sword, and I all know he is now out of it, taking all the money away. And the next person who is following him is Mr. Nirav Modi, took 11,400 crore from PNB and is now living heavily outside, and we are just waving and doing nothing because we allow other rich people to borrow money and go and do nothing. Moving to next question, the contentious Baglihar Dam, answer is Chenab. Guys, you should be thorough with the various dams in India because a question pertaining to dams, centuries, etc. are also relevant for CLAT examinations as well as ILET. Moving to next question, which country has its richest man as head of government? The answer to it is Saudi Arabia. 50 option C. Moving to next question, who was the person father of modern India? Answer is Kishore Biyani. I think you have knowing it very well because Kishore Biyani, I hope you know him. He is the person behind Pantaloons. So you would be knowing it very well. The answer to this question is Kishore Biyani, 51, option B. Next question, the largest software service company in Asia. The answer is Tata Consultancy Service. Tata Consultancy Service is the largest software service company in Asia. Next question, Tychonaut. See, Tychonaut, Astronaut and Cosmonaut. All three are for persons with same means jobs. But astronaut is basically for the English countries like America and that. And in Russia, we call them as cosmonaut. As you know, Rakesh Sharma was an Indian cosmonaut because he went via Russia. So, a astronaut in Russia is called cosmonaut, while an astronaut in China is called taikonaut. Regarding the one thing also, I want to do some facts, like question could also come that Sunita Williams went in space by which aircraft. The answer was that she went to space by Discovery. And from which space shuttle was Kalpana Chawla returning when she died? So answer is Columbia. And she died in which year? So answer is 1 February 2003. So regarding some astro knowledge also you should have about the spaceships and space shuttles which are carrying, when was, what was the name of the space shuttle which Nick Armstrong went to the moon. So these things also you should be aware of. Next question, the CEO of Microsoft Corporation. See now guys, this is an old question. So that time the CEO was different, but now you should know the current CEO of Microsoft, that is Satya Nadella, okay? And the CEO of Google, that is Sundar Pichai. Both were of Indian origin, so you should know very well. I hope you know the founders of both, so I will not discuss that. The next question, the country which stands for gross national happiness. The answer to this question is option Bhutan. Bhutan country, it was bought by his king, that is the Jigme Singwe Wangchuk. He bought, crossed out this term, gross national happiness. The next question is highest paid head of the government. The answer to this question is option C, Singapore. Moving to next question, the current impasse in the Doha round negotiations is certained around. So you know Doha round negotiations are recently, our prime minister also visited there. But answer to this is agriculture subsidies provided by developed countries, that is 57, option C. The phenomena called equinox is due to when? So you should know the dates of equinox and the solstice because they are two geographical terms. Equinox basically happens because of the revolution of Earth on its inclined axis. It occurs twice in India, twice across the world, 20th March and 22nd September. These are the dates for the equinox. Moving to next question. So option 258 is option B. Question number 59. Director General of WTO. There is no present director name in this question because it is an old question. So at present, the director of WTO is Azevedo. I don't know his first name, but his surname is Azevedo. A-Z-E-V-E-D-O. The WTO, you should know, it was earlier known as GAT, General Agreement on Trade and Tariff. Later on, it during the Marrakesh Treaty, it was converted into WTO as World Trade Organization. The next question is capital account convertibility. So basically it signifies about the option number C, ensuring free international movement of capital. We can also, you should know a fact that capital account convertibility is also known as capital asset liberalization. Capital asset liberation, because of that center on the ability, it has the ability of the center to conduct transactions of local financial assets. So basically we allow some movement of capital in the international market. So that's why capital account convertibility, answer is option C. What was the purpose of Kyoto Protocol? You would all be knowing, you have heard this term during the EVE subject which you have studied in your earlier classes. The answer to this question is D, because it was to put a limit on the greenhouse gas emissions by state. The next question, what do carbon credits signify? Carbon credits basically signify the entitlements to emit certain quantity of greenhouse gases. So answer to it is option B. The Question number 63. The practice of selling goods. So this you all know. What China is doing in India? That's the answer of it. China is doing dumping by selling their goods in our country at lower prices than our own goods. So they are enriching their own profits. The answer to this question is B. 64. Which of the following is considered as bulwark of personal freedom? Very easy question. It has been asked many of the times. Answer is habeas corpus. What does habeas corpus means? You have a body. In which article does we have writ jurisdiction? Of Supreme Court, we have under 32, while for High Courts, we have in 226. The writ jurisdiction power of High Courts is greater than Supreme Courts because High Courts can have writ jurisdiction over fundamental rights as well as legal rights, which Supreme Court don't have. Right apart mandamus, mandamus means we command. Be like the person who are not performing their functions, so writ jurisdiction can be commend on them so that they perform their duty. And most important thing is that in your legal portion also, whenever question comes, you should keep in mind that fundamental rights are enforced only against state, not against private individuals. Next question is Vande Mataram composed by. Very easy question again. It was composed by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. It was composed by him. It was very popular during the anti-partition movement, which occurred in 1906. Next question. From how many degrees each? So is this question answer is A, option 4 minutes. 1 degree difference of that longitude and latitude is equal to the 4 minutes. If you remember, you have studied in your geography classes around 6th, 7th classes that we used to find the calculations for the time when we crossed the Greenwich by a plane. So we used to do the calculations. So we kept in mind that 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. Next question, Article 1. Article 1. You should have seen my previous videos about the articles. I have made 2 videos and I have discussed very important articles for CLAT. Here the present answer is 67, option B. Option C. It talks about India as a union of state. So 67 answer is C. Question number 68. Which is the highest body that approves 5-year plans? So now you should know that 5-year plans body, which was made by planning commissions, that body is now not longer known as planning commission. It is known as Niti Aayog, and no more 5-year plans are made. But that highest body which used to approve 5-year plans was National Development Council. That is option C. The next question. Who developed or scientifically determined the national income in India? Answer is option B. Mr. Dr. V. K. R. V. Rao. Next question. Who is the following largest peninsula? Answer is Arabian Peninsula. The person responsible for economic model for Indian planning, none other than P.C. Mahanobis. The second 5-year plan is known after him. It is known as Mahanobis model, when we stressed more on industrialization. In the first 5-year plan, which was known as Harold Domer model, we gave more emphasis on agriculture, while in second we gave more emphasis on that industrialization. Next question, social forestry aims at. Answer to this question is option C, large scale afforestation. Afforestation basically means planting of more and more trees. The Great Barrier Reef. The Great Barrier Reef, this you all would be knowing if you have seen the Australia logos. It is situated in Australia. It is regarding the coral formation, coral reefs. So coral formation, option A. A nautical mile. 1 nautical mile is equal to approx 1.85 kilometer. So if you convert it into meters by multiplying into 1000, it would be around 1852 meters. But since the closest option to it is option A, so answer is option A. Which of the following is concerned with landforms? Now this question is a tricky one because geology, geomorphology, geography, these are closely somewhat related because you know all studied geography, also studied physical landforms, geology about earth. But the answer to it is geomorphology because morph means shape. So the shape of the landforms and all covers in the geomorphology. So option B. The country known as Land of Midnight Sun. Very easy question again. The option to it is Norway. Norway is known as Land of Midnight Sun and Japan is known as Land of Rising Sun. Next question. The monk who spread Buddhism in Tibet and Far East. The answer to this question is C. Padmasambhav. He was the monk who spread it in the Tibet and Far East. Next question. Trips. So this question forms an important as you will study the intellectual property rights, that is IPR. IPR is very important because you study them at CLAT legal examinations, because CLAT legal reasoning question comes from TRIPS about copyright, trademark, geographical indication. So you should be aware of it, patents. So TRIPS was basically for setting up the IPR. So it answer would be option number C. Apart from it, you should also know about Vienna Convention. Vienna Convention was basically for the diplomatic relations. You need to provide a diplomatic immunity. So these conventions regarding the IPRs, TRIPS, etc., you should also be aware. What is the limit granted during a patent? The patent maximum limit is for 20 years. Limit for trademark also, etc., you should be aware of. Next question moving is carbon dating. So answer to this question is fossils. 79B was the next question is managing director of Delhi Metro Railway Corporation. Answer is very easy. Mr. C. Sridharan. The answer itself is in the option C and C. 81 question. 18 karat gold. This is very easy question. As you all know, 24 karat gold mean pure gold, and when it means 18 karat, it will surely means that 18 part is gold and remaining 6 is of some other. So option number B. Second question is Bali roadmap adopted in December. The answer to this question is option number A, that is fixation of greenhouse gas emission limits. Next question, enriched uranium. So see, you all know that in nuclear reactors basically we use uranium as a source because it is a radioactive element. So answer to when uranium is free from all the impurities, it is known as enriched uranium. Next question, scientist responsible for developing atomic energy, Mr. Homi J. Bhabha. Answer is B. He is known as father of Indian nuclear energy. Answer is Homi J. Salwa Judumi. This question is very important. It has been asked 2-3 times in CLAT. Basically, it was answer is B. In that, civilians are provided arms to fight against the militants. This is very popular against the Naxal movements in the areas of Chhattisgarh. Regarding Naxal movement also, I would like to say you should search somewhat of info, because Naxal movement is not from right now. It started much earlier. It started from the Naxal Badi village in the West Bengal, and the main leader who started this movement was Charu Majumdar. So you should have some info regarding Naxal movements too. Next part is Indian who won. This question is irrelevant because 2007 they will never ask. The 87th question also irrelevant. No need to go through it. Then the next question, free trade area. Basically, free trade area does not mean that you have the trade free. It basically means that the import or export duties which are in that particular region, they are substantially reduced. So answer to this question is option B, where the barriers have been reduced. Next is affirmative action. As I was saying, affirmative action in the reservation case. So basically what happens to the deprived and the marginalized sections when we provide them some upliftment, it is termed as affirmative action. So the answer to this question is B, welfare measures to alleviate the sufferings of poor people. Next is special economic zones. Special economic zones are basically that zones where, you know, I would like to say that some when you do trades or particular transactions, so in that area you don't have that more strict laws. So law are somewhat lenient and barriers are also much lenient. So answer to this question is C, the places where industries get certain tax advantage so that they can easily have some their transactions. Next question, the space shuttle which successfully, see the question came here. I was just telling you like you should know about the space shuttles. The question came by which space shuttle Sunita Williams went to space. So answer is Discovery. And Kalpana Chawla died while returning to the space. The answer would be Columbus. The next is the leader who led the country in atoning the past wrongs. The answer to this question is C option, that is Kevin Rudd. Next question, Gandhiji expounded his economic ideas. You know Gandhiji's autobiography. So it is My Experiments in Truth. It was translated in English by Mahadev Desai. And you should be aware about the national movement. My next video, national movement, will also be uploaded soon. Gandhiji, three major movements in the national movement are 1920 non-cooperation, 1931 civil disobedience, and the Dandi March, you cannot forget. Apart from it, there is Quit India movement of 1942. Then the Gandhi-Irwin Pact of 1931 also you should remember. You should also know that during the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy in 1913, Gandhiji renounced his what? Title known as Kesar A Hind, which was conferred by the Britishers. He renounced that title. And one question can also come like in which part of South Africa Gandhiji was thrown from train. So answer today is Pietermaritzburg. Maritzburg. At that particular place Gandhiji was thrown from the train because of the color practice which was prevalent in South Africa known as apartheid, the racial discrimination. Next question is biofuels have become controversial. See, basically biofuels are what? Biofuels means using from plants we are making food. So if you are using plants, it will seriously make our agricultural production go slow. So the answer to this is what? They reduce food cultivation. 94 C. Next question, evergreening of patents. See, evergreening of patents is particularly a strategy basically. So you should know that it is used by pharmaceuticals to make their own things which is benefit for others. So the option to this answer is C. Next question is why assigning which pact? Very easy question again. It is the Pune Pact in the year of 1932, just after the year of civil disobedience movement. In this, there was for the depressed class, separate electoral concepts was raised. Next question is, India earns maximum foreign exchange from export of. So this question, accordingly to this paper, the answer which was there, it was gems. But if you look at that maximum foreign exchange in many sites on Google, it speaks regarding tea. So if option is tea, I would say to mark tea. Next is Sunita Williams hold world record. Sunita Williams went to space by, I just told you earlier, if you have not listened to me, just go back, rewind the video and follow it. The answer to this question is option A, 195. The second biggest greenhouse gas emitter after USA, none other than China, larger population, more pollution. Though India is also larger pollution in terms of strength, but we are still much behind China. The next question is, the author of the management principle in hierarchy, every employee tend to rise his level of incompetence. The answer to this question is Professor, any guesses? Answer is Professor J. Peter. So option 100, option 100 question, option B. The next is, World Trade Organization was earlier known, as I have told earlier, only the question which came earlier, World Trade Organization was known as GATT, General Agreement on Trade and Tariff. During the Marrakesh Treaty, it was known as World Trade Organization. The Wailing Wall is associated with, simple answer is Jews. An education minister who got Bharat Ratna. Bharat Ratna was first time won by Abul Kalam Azad. He was even the first education minister of a country. You should know Bharat Ratna, it has been given to how many persons? Who was the last person to win? And who were the first three persons? So they were started during the year 1954. They were won by three persons at first, Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, C.V. Raman, and third person, I leave to you to find out. Please comment on the video. I will assure that I will reply to all. Why is ozone layer important? Very easy question from class 2nd, 3rd only. You start learning that why ozone is important during our science books. So answer it is, it protects the earth from ultraviolet radiation. Option A. World's largest river. What is the world's largest river? World's largest river is Nile. If it comes to the Indian text, so I will say mark the longest river as Ganga, while the largest river as Brahmaputra, because in terms of largest, it means basically the terms of quantity of water flow. So in quantity way, it is Brahmaputra, but for the longest, it is Ganga. And from where Ganga originates, as you all know, Gangotri Glacier. Next question, tsunami is caused by, answer is underwater volcanic activity, that is option C. Then next is, the Chipko movement is associated with, it is basically associated with from prevent the felling of trees. So the answer to it is option A. It was basically started from the time of 1970s at particularly the area which was known as Garhwali Mountains. Garhwali Mountains are in that Uttarakhand area. So it was started in that region, and a very famous person associated with it is Sundarlal Bahugane. Agle question baat hai. Greatest Indian Empire. Which was the greatest Indian Empire? Aap sabko pata hi hoga ki Magad Empire, jispe pehle Nanda ka rules tha, uske baad हमारे मौर्यंस जो चाणक्य के साथ मिलकर चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य स्टार्टेड हिज ओन डायनेस्टी विच वॉज नोन एज मगध डायनेस्टी विच हैड हिज अनदर फेमस रूलर अशोक हु फॉट द बैटल ऑफ कलिंग 261 BC. सो आपको ये सारी चीज़ें पता होनी चाहिए. हिस्ट्री, एंशियंट हिस्ट्री के भी वीडियोस मैं बनाऊंगा ताकि आप लोग का भला हो. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द फर्स्ट प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस. वेरी इजी. फर्स्ट प्रेसिडेंट वॉज W.C. बनर्जी. Where it was held in Bombay. The second session was held in Calcutta. Who presided that second session? Then the next question would become that who was the founder of Indian National Congress? Answer will be A.O. Hume. It was founded in 1885. And basically what Lord Dufferin used to address Congress, who was that time Governor General, he used to address Congress as a microscopic minority. Next question is the king who gave permission to establish East India Company. Answer is Jahangir. You all know that during 1605, the ambassador of English came to his court, Mr. Thomas Rowe. Later on, William Hawkins also arrived at him, and they were given the permission to open one of their settlement in that area of Surat, Gujarat. Next, person who conceptualized the idea of Pakistan. According to it, the options you can easily mark Muhammad Iqbal. But if the question comes, who coined the term Pakistan? The answer will be what? Rehmat Ali. Mr. Rehmat Ali coined the first word for Pakistan. And you should know about national movement if you have studied, like who was the founder of Muslim League and how the demand of Pakistan rose. So you should know somewhat of contextualized theory also. Next question is Khilafat movement was organized by. So it was occurred during the year 1919. Gandhiji also have given impetus because he wanted to establish the Hindu-Muslim unity. Basically, the answer to this question is to preserve Turkish Empire with Khilafat. That is option C. Next, the pattern of center-state relation. It can be similarly traced from the Motilal Nehru Committee report. Answer is option C. And one question in my mind is just striking, like it can be asked in that examination, that which commission is basically for the center-state relation. So if option come as Sarkariya Commission, so mark that, because these commissions are very important. There are many commissions which are important, like the Thakur Commission, which was set for the committee to look after the assassination of Indira Gandhi, then Kothari Commission for educational reforms, then we have Chelia Commission for banking that, and we have your Malia Commission, that is for criminal justice, and Liberhan Commission for the Ayodhya Babri Masjid demolition. So these commissions are very important. Sa Commission for that, the Sikh riots that time. So these all serves an important, you should look through it. Even the current affairs section commissions are somewhat constituted, so you should note it. Moving to next question. Who played very role in World Communist Movement? Answer is M.N. Roy. You all know one person, he is very popular. Who was the first recipient of Jnanpith? It is G. Shankar Kurup. G. Shankar Kurup won the Jnanpith Award. Name the winner. This question is again not important because it was, what you can say, 2007. You should know regarding the current, that is 2017, because from 2018 they have not been released. Then for question plea bargaining is, the answer would be option D. It is allowed with the subject to the prior permission of courts. Next question, person appointed by two parties to settle a dispute, answer will be option B. Question number next, right to travel is a fundamental right under, now right to travel. If you have seen my important cases videos, I have made a video on the important cases in which I have discussed Menaka Gandhi versus Union of India. It was very important landmark case regarding right to travel abroad, in that her passport was impounded. But later the court held that right to travel is also emanated under Article 21, right to life and personal liberty. So answer to this question is, right to travel is fundamental right under Article 21. Next question, 120th, answer, genetically modified seeds have become controversial. See, when you do some changes basically on a particular natural thing, sometimes they though have positive effects, but there are some cons too. So answer to is this, they have an adverse effect on the flora around. So option B. Next question, legal aid for an accused. So before coming to this question, you must know in which article legal aid is constituted. So answer would be 39A. But you should know right to free legal aid is a fundamental right. And what is 39A? 39 is DPSP, that is Directive Principles of State Policy, mentioned in the Part 4 of Indian Constitution. Next question, members of Constituent Assembly who framed the constitution were, answer is that they were indirectly elected. They were elected during, by the, like each member represented the 1 lakh people of that India that time. So Constituent Assembly members, they are that time, members are chosen from the princely states, British India and the 4 commissionary states, Barku. I will post a video about the Constituent Assembly also in the coming days. So I will discuss this section very briefly and in elaborate also in that video. Look to it that later on. The next question is, Ambedkar acted in Constituent Assembly, as you all know he was the chairman of drafting committees, option B. Next, India international treaties are ratified by, C. In this question, answer is Parliament. It is the Parliament who ratifies the international treaty. Article, you should know that the article which is in the constitution, just try to search it out so that it might help you, because some relevant articles also help you. And if you look to my previous videos, I have also mentioned that article in my video. Next question, it is a constitutional requirement Parliament shall meet at least, very easy again, twice a year, because there should not be a gap of more than how many months? 6 months between 2 Parliament meetings. So answer is twice a year. Governor of state can be removed by, very easy again, President. So in which article governor is mentioned? Governor is mentioned under Article 153. And if you read that article, you can know very well that governor is always appointed at the pleasure of president. Yani president ki jab marzi karegi unko hata sakte hain. Aur emergency ke liye, like jo 356 article hai, governor jab chahta hai to report bana ke president ko bhejta hai ki state mein constitutional machinery jo hai kharab chal rahi hai, constitution ke provisions pe state kaam nahi kar pa rahi hai, to governor ke kehne pe president state mein जो भी आपकी सरकार होगी उसको अन्यूल कर सकता है, उसको गिरा सकता है. नेक्स्ट इज सॉवरेनिटी अंडर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बिलोंग्स टू, वेरी इजी, सॉवरेनिटी बिलोंग्स टू द पीपल, बिकॉज इफ यू रीड द प्रीएम्बल इट सेज वी द पीपल, सो ऑल द सॉवरेनिटी इट इज बेसिकली फॉर द पीपल. The Supreme Court upheld Mandal Commission. As I discussed earlier, Mandal Commission report. Mandal Commission was which case? Indira Sahone versus Union of India. So option B. Under a constitution, right to property. This question is very well asked because right to property earlier was a part of fundamental right. But during the 44th Amendment Act, it was removed and placed in the article of constitution, which is the article 300 sub clause A. But now its present status is that it is the constitutional right. Option C. Next question, chairman of 6th pay commission. The answer to this question is very easy because answer is B and C, Krishna, but you should not look on to this question. You should rather look for the 7th pay commission, which is now in news, and the chairman of 7th pay commission is who? He is A.K. Mathur. Right to education emanates from, again a question, you should know that right to education emanates from option D, that is the right to life and personal liberty, that is article 21. Next, International Court of Justice. If you know the parts of UN, you will simply know that the main, it is a very principal organ of UNO. Apart from General Assembly, Security Council, Trusteeship Council and the Secretariat, International Court of Justice with its headquarters in Hague is an important part. And you should know that three Indians have also served there, Mr. Justice Dalveer Bhandari and two other, Nagendra Singh. One other, I leave to you to comment and I will check whether the answer is right or wrong. Next, the Labour and Commission. See, as I was discussing earlier, Labour and Commission came. These commissions are important. So the answer to this, as I have discussed earlier, answer is demolition of Babri Masjid, 133, option C. The Monopolies and this Act. This Act was replaced by the Competition Act in 2002. Okay, next question. Judge against whom motion of impeachment? Answer is Justice Ramaswamy. It has been asked 2-3 times in the Clat and aniket examination. So answer is option B. The Malimat Committee. See, I was discussing and again that things prove it because these questions have been repeated. So the Malimat Committee report basically deals with the what? Criminal justice reforms. So option B. First woman justice of High Court. Very easy, Leela Seth. But the question comes for the Chief Justice of India. Then answer would be Fatima Sahib, Fatima Bibi. And when question comes regarding the first woman advocate, answer would be Cornelia Sorabji. You should learn the list of the first in India, whether male or female, and first in world, whether male or female. That is very important. Next question is, Lok Adalats have been created under what? Lok Adalats have been created under Legal Service Authorities Act. So answer will be, in which year it came? It came in year 1987 to provide right to free legal aid, and very other provisions were put in the Legal Service Authority Act. So option is answer A. Next question. Recent Nepal elections are globally significant. It was that time very popular in the CLAT during the year 2008. So that time the answer to this question would be, if you can guess, it is somewhat even relevant today also, that when you see movements occur in Nepal. So option is C. The next question, third world leader who has been defying the USA. Very easy, if you can just look, if you know somewhat of international news knowledge, answer is Fidel Castro of Cuba. So answer is A. Now, after doing so, let's move with the legal reasoning section now. As you see, the first question from the question number 176. On the death of a husband, the widow shall not. First, reading the facts. See, since when Sudhir died, he had 1/3 share of the family property, which the three brothers, Sudhir and Yashwin, inherited from their brothers. Sudhir died on EA without having an issue. The widow of Sudhir, Mr. Bin. Now you see from the question, Sudhir had died leaving some property and he died on 23rd 2006, and the widow has married on 2007, and the transaction of that property to carried on was done on that, the demand for which was raised on the January 30, 2007. Now widow ne usse demand kari property ki 30, that is after marriage. And if you read the principle which is your principle number 2, that is a widow cannot claim the property of the deceased if on the date when the question of succession opens she has remarried. Since usne 1 Jan ko marriage kar li thi and she has claimed after 29 days on 30th, since it is violating principle 2, so she is not entitled for the claim. Hence the option which will be can judge first of all is that she cannot inherit. So option A, coupled with the reason, now we should find out the reasons which would be the most. First of all, check the option. See, the A option, there are two options. So now from that, you can see the reasons which are more accurate. So since the second reason, that is Win has remarried, is more accurate. So answer for this question would be option B, that says A2. Moving to the next question. Next question is, if a person commits any act, death, causing another person, and act is done with the intention the person is not liable for murder, a person has right of self-defense to the extent of causing death to another, provided he apprehends death by the act of later. Coming to the facts, Shubha went to hardware store and so now you see in this question, the husband went to the shop, he was altercation happened and the Shubha picked up sharp object and hit him. Later when wife came to enter to save her husband, she was also being hit. Husband, in order to save his wife, he tried to give a severe blow with a sharp object and he died. Now if you read the principle one, it says that there should be intention of causing death, then it is liable for murder. But if you see the facts, there was not intention to kill him, rather the intention was to save him and his wife from the attack of Shubha. So the principle one itself does not follow. And now you read the principle two, a person has a right of self-defense to the extent of causing death if he apprehends death. As you can see that he was hit, he was bleeding and his wife also was being hurt and knocked consciousness. So there was a reasonability that could be apprehended that they both could be killed by Shubha. Hence he made a severe blow to Shubha. So principle two is applicable and principle one is applicable in the favor of his self-defense because it was not murder since his intention was not to kill, rather to save himself. So this killing will not amount to murder. See, the option C, that is Anup killed. So possible decisions would be C. Now we should look on the options, which option says for C. Option A does not say for C, B also not, C also, C only says D. Since it is very clear now that only option C speaks for that reason or decision of C, hence we should not look on the reasons and move ahead with option C. The next is consumer goods which are not fit for consumption or not marketable, the consumer shall not account, the principles remaining. Then Ram bought the Coca-Cola bottle back at home and he opened the glass. As Tom started drinking, he felt irritation immediately. Ram, Tom and nitric acid was found. Ram filed a suit. So moving to the facts, so there was a simple, you can read that the Coca-Cola was bought from a shop and both had he was served to Tom and due to the nitric acid present he choked. So now we are options, Ram cannot get compensation, Tom can get, both can get. So let's read the principles. Consumer goods which are not fit for consumption are not marketable. Okay. A consumer shall not suffer on account of unmarketable goods. Okay. A seller is liable for knowingly selling unmarketable goods. Okay. A manufacturer shall be liable for the quality of his products. Manufacturer shall be liable for quality of his product. Ab dekhiye, Coca-Cola manufacture ki gayi thi. Ab to manufacturer ki kuch to responsibility banti hai. Okay. अब यानी कि जो reasons हमारे पास हैं, अब यहाँ पे अगर confusion reasons पे हो कि reasons में manufacturer तो liable होगा, सीधी सी बात है, तो Coca-Cola is responsible, यानी एक reason ऐसा है, यानी fourth option वाला, तो आप इसको भी cross tally कर सकते हो, कौन से option में fourth option के साथ decision को annul मतलब mix किया गया है, सीधे सीधे देख रहा है कि option D में ही सिर्फ fourth option को हमने include किया है, तो हम बिना कुछ options देखे ही D को mark कर देंगे. Hence, legal reasoning में अगर आपका एक element भी match कर रहा है और options में आपको दिख रहा है तो आपको आगे जाने की need नहीं है and you can save your time. यही time आप बचा के आगे questions में use कर सकते हो. Moving to next question. A is asked to do something in this. Okay. A acting commits a wrong. Okay. If he is authorized to do something but in the nature of disclosing, both A and B will be held liable. So, अब इसमें fact ये है कि Somu contacted with Amar. ये scene है. Amar would buy a pump set. Such a pump set was in short supply. Gulab, a dealer, had a pump set refused. Okay. So, see, similarly, if you read the first principle, first of all, A is asked to do something by B. B is responsible for the act, not A. Yani, main agar koi cheez karne ko kisi ko kahunga, to wo banda responsible hoga. Maine kisi ko kaha, like, if I am A and I have said something to which is to be done, okay, by another person, then that person is responsible. I am not responsible. That person is responsible. And if A, while acting for B, commits a wrong, like the person to whom have ended a work does something wrong, then that person is liable, not me. So these two principles. And if the person to have given the work, he does the work without telling about my intention that I am the main person because of whom he is doing the work, then both would be liable. So in this case, Somu contracted with Amar where under Amar would buy a pump set. So aniki, follow the principles, that is principle number two. First of all, let's see. If A, while acting for B, commits a wrong, yani Amar acted on part of Somu, okay, So Amar acted and then he threatened Gulab. So since Amar is acting on part of Somu and he has done a wrong, because threatening a person is a wrong. So it means that the person, that is Amar, would be liable, not Sonu. So we coming to the option, we can see that Amar alone is liable. The answer would start from option A. Now we need to search for the possible reasons. So first see the options. So options only two, A1 and A2 could be seen. So let's judge which will be suitable. So suggestions are: Amar committed the wrong while acting for the benefit of Somu. Amar cannot do while acting for Somu, which he cannot do. So if you see at the first reason, it is more accurate and more connected to the principle also. So answer would be option A, that is A1 of the question number 179. Moving to the next question. In this, there was water flowing below land. He has constructed a reservoir below and which drew the water. So the person joining it could not share the water. Now if you look at the principle, first of all, water blowing below your land is not yours, though you can use it. Any obstruction on your land belongs to you. Yani main apne jeevan mein kuch bhi banaunga, mera hai. And if water is flowing, mera nahi hai, but I could use it. So in this case, since he had made a huge reservoir, but he had made this on his land. So since his construction is of the person Suresh, so he does not need to demolish the reservoir. So the answer should start with A, kyunki uski jameen mein banaya tha usne. So options should start with A. Now check the option starting with A. Or the option starting with A are only option A. Hence the answer would be A. We should not look for the reason, because you, as you can see, only the decision is only one option, that is A3, which is given in the option A. So just mark it and save your time moving ahead. Next, employer shall be liable for the wrongs committed by the employees. Nandan was a syndicate bank to collect savings, customer in different places, Nigamma, housemaid. So in this case, Nandan was appointed. So bank knew that his work was to do the work and he will do. And later on, the bank, he made him away from his services. But the Nandan continued his transactions with Nagamma. So the third parties, read the second principle, which is third parties must exercise reasonable care to find out the person is actually in the course of employment or not. So ab yahan pe bank was aware that Nandan was earlier doing his duty of collecting funds. So later on, when the person went away, Nagamma still deposited the money without knowing. As you can see that the third parties must exercise reasonable care to find out whether a person is actually in the course of employment or not. So in this case, if you read the second principle, you can come to the direct conclusion that the second principle accordingly answer would be starting from somewhat that bank would be liable, because read this option, person cannot blame for others for his own negligence. Nagamma was entitled to be informed by bank is entitled to expect from its own. So the answer would be option C, because looking from the starting, syndicate bank shall be liable. As I have told you earlier, that bank was knowing that he is collecting funds at the earlier when he was at his employee. But later on, since bank is the third party now here between Nagamma and that person, so bank duty was to inform. Hence the bank would be liable. You could judge from the easily and move to the options, seeking which option starts from A. Since only one option starts from A, the answer would be C. Moving to the next question. Ramabai was an educated widow. She opened account, okay, bank with the help of nephew Keshav. Okay, nephew was a clerk and Keshav used to deposit money. See, now from the facts in the previous question and this question, you read very carefully, you will be able to understand. Yahan pe jo banda tha, he was a clerk. His duty was not to deposit between them and that. In the earlier question, Nandan, who was the worker, he was asked to collect, means he was working only for the collection. But in this, the person is working as a clerk, and the nature which was between Ramabai and Keshav was of private, means they both knew, bank was unaware about it, they were doing it in their personal capacity. So in this case, applying the principles, the bank will not be liable because bank was unaware about such contract. So in this case, the third party would be who? The Ramabai. He should have used according to the principle number, was the principle this. Both master and third party must exercise reasonable care in this regard. Any option three principle which is there, you should follow this principle accordingly. Then you will see that bank is not liable because Here, bank was not aware about their personal capacity. So the bank is not liable. Means the option stood apart from B. So if we look at the option starting from B, we see only option C, which is starting with B, and option D. But now we should check in C and D, which is better one. The reasons are for B2, that the bank was not aware of special arrangement and cashier was not applied. Since the principle 3 is much connected to that, the reasonable care, since the reasonable care point is much connected to B2, that is the bank was not aware of special arrangement, answer would be C. Moving to next question. A cricket match, okay, this is a very normal question. Voluntary non-fit injury, yeah, since he was sitting himself on the tree, he himself took the risk. So he will simply, the organizers would not be liable. Applying the principles here, first of all, you can see from here by the facts that, and the principle that B, answer would starting from the B. So looking at the options which are there, if any option is starting with B, only option C is starting from B. Hence answer would be undoubtedly what? C. That is B2. Question again, next one, a patient diagnosed from stomach ailment approached attending teaching hospital, it was diagnosed appendix, was removed. Okay. When a person unlawfully, now you see that hospital on seeing that he was suffering from disease took that out. Hence it was a necessity, it was not done unlawfully. So he has not committed, the hospital has not committed the tort of conversion according to Lee principle 1. And second principle, if we look, nobody shall enrich himself at other expense. Now you look, since following the first principle, first of all, the hospital is not at fault. Coming to second, the hospital has not enriched on that appendix cells which he had. The hospital had done their own studies also to find it out, since the hospital will not be liable to share accordingly the principle 2, because it himself has also contributed to something. It was not done because only for the commercial thing. Hence the option would be that hospital need not to start. So answer would start from C. That is option A. It should start from option A. Now looking on the options which start from A, only option A and B suggest that A1 or A2. Now to choose the best, read 1 and 2 reasons. That is patient far from being deprived, that is vague. The hospital, instead of throwing away, conducted further research. Hence the answer to it would be A2, because it is much more connected. So option would be B. Moving to next question. Rohini is an exam PUC. She was conducting authorized pen instrument as she was writing paper. Come okay. Negative test putney found. Chits contained. Rohini answer. Okay. So in this case, suppose it happens with many times in school also, like we were there, we were properly checked. We did not have anything, but something is lying and we were caught. But applying principles number 1, copying include attempt to copy in examination is a serious offense. One shall not take any unauthorized material into the examination hall. Following the principle 2, you can blindly see in this case that she had not taken any unauthorized materials. It was not her fault if it is there. She was checked. Hence, she did not carry any unauthorized material. Hence, she cannot be set for copying anything. Hence, Rohini cannot be punished. Answer should start from the B reason. Now, check on the options which start from B. The options which start from B are C and D. Now, you should use the principles and the facts to judge which would be better. Reasons are something lying in the feet does not mean that person is positioned. Okay, the fact that she has checked thoroughly while getting, since checking one is not clearly given in the principle, only the thing which is clearly that copying include attempt to copy examination is serious offense, and she was instrument, all things were properly checked. Hence the most is that you cannot say a person is having in a possession of that particular thing. So the best answer for this would be your option D. According to me, it should be option D, because since the possession of that thing was not there with that lady, she should not be held liable for copying. Moving to the next. This 186, if you see, if you apply your contracts, you all know that when agreement is there, then only contract is there. Okay. So first of all, you should not apply a contract here in this question, because it's a mere syllogism question. If you do syllogisms by Venn diagram, you could move Venn diagram. But if you prefer syllogisms by that tick cross method in which we distribute the subject, then case you should follow the syllogisms rule, because this tick cross method is comparatively much more easier than your Venn diagram method. So I think it would be better for me first to discuss with you syllogisms, then moving to these questions. So I will discuss remaining these questions in my logical reasoning video, compounding with the syllogism part. So let's hope for that the next video I'm surely going to discuss these all three questions remaining, plus the logical plus English. Till that time, please go through this my case of analysis of the case analysis or the question paper analysis of CLAT 2008 paper, and subscribe my channel and like the video.